Namaste, Save the Soil, Pracheka interview Swagatum, Eros Manatoka, Visishta Atidhi Hunar, one of the most powerful Indians of this century, one of the most powerful spiritual leaders of this country, Padma Vibhushan, Sadhguru. So, to ఆధ్యాత్మికతను ఇటు ఆధునికతను సమానంగా పుణికిపుచ్చుకున్న ఈ ప్రపంచ ప్రసిద్ధ యోగి ఇప్పుడు ఒక సాహసయాత్ర చేస్తున్నారు. ఈ 65 ఏళ్ల వయసులో 100 రోజుల్లో సుమారుగా 24 దేశాల్లో 30,000 కిలోమీటర్లు పర్యటించి, అది కూడా ఒక మోటార్ బైక్ మీద పర్యటించి ఆయన ఒక మహోత్కృష్టమైన పని చేస్తున్నారు. ఏమిటంటే సేవ్ ది సాయిల్ అనే పేరుతో ఒక ప్రాజెక్ట్ని చేపట్టారు. సో క్షీణించి అంతరించిపోతున్న భూసారాన్ని పరిరక్షించండి అంటూ వేడుకుంటున్నారు ఇప్పుడు ఈ ప్రపంచ ప్రసిద్ధ యోగి. సో ఈ యోగి అభ్యర్థనకు ప్రపంచ దేశాలు ఏ విధంగా స్పందిస్తున్నాయి, అలాగే ఎటువంటి రెస్పాన్స్ ఆయన సేవ్ ది సాయిల్కి లభిస్తుంది అనే అంశాలు మాట్లాడేందుకు మనతో ప్రత్యక్షంగా ఉన్నారు సద్గురు. నమస్కారం సద్గురు. సో 90 రోజులు దాటింది మీరు ప్రపంచ యాత్ర ప్రారంభించి లండన్ నుంచి స్వదేశానికి మిడిల్ ఈస్ట్ మీదుగా తిరిగి వచ్చారు. సో ఎలా ఉంది, మీరు ట్రావెల్ చేస్తున్న బైక్ ఈజ్ బిఎండబ్ల్యూ కే 1600 జీటీ. సో ఈ మోటార్ బైక్ ట్రావెల్ ఫ్రమ్ యూరోప్ టు ఇండియా, ఎటువంటి రెస్పాన్స్ వచ్చింది, అసలు ఈ సేవ్ ది సాయిల్ అనే ఆలోచన మీకు ఎలా వచ్చింది?
సీ ద రెస్పాన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ద పీపుల్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ స్పెక్టాక్యులర్ అబౌట్ హౌ దిస్ మూమెంట్ స్టార్టెడ్. హీస్ ఐ హావ్ బీన్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ సాయిల్ ఫర్ ఓవర్ 30 ఇయర్స్ నౌ. ఐ హావ్ స్పోకన్ టు వేరియస్ మినిస్ట్రీస్, బ్యూరోక్రాట్స్, సాయిల్ సైంటిస్ట్స్, ఫ్యూ ఆఫ్ ద హెడ్స్ ఆఫ్ స్టేట్. Everybody says, Sadhguru, what you're saying is great, this must happen, and then they'll sleep on it. So, I thought we need to do something to wake up people, because democratically elected leaders will wake up only when people want it. So, we wanted to create a people's movement, as we did for Rally for Rivers. 162 million people across the country responded in just 29 days. So, this we wanted to activate 60% of the world's adult population, which amounts to 3.6 billion people. How do I do it? I don't hold any position of power. I have no authority in the world. The only thing I have is people's love and goodwill. So I've been talking to these people also, but they think it's tomorrow's problem. Sometime when it comes, we will see kind of thing. They don't understand the problem is already evolving and advanced to a stage where it's threatening our life, not even future generations. So I had to do something that puts me to risk, but not sure death. If I try to cycle, that's sure death. If I try to walk, it's sure death. Motorcycle is
relatively better.
Possible death. So the moment they saw that Sadhguru could kill himself, everybody woke up and they're all supporting in a big way. 2.8 billion people are supporting the movement now, and I'm very sure in the next few weeks we will reach the number that we want to reach. And the social media metrics do not cover the WhatsApp reach. We do not know the WhatsApp reach. Already that number could have happened, we do not know, but we are going by the metrics. But now one thing that's happened is the narrative in the world, among the governments, among the leaders, the narrative has shifted towards soil. 100%. So we have no doubt whether it'll happen or not. Now the only concern is the speed at which it'll happen. It must happen very rapidly so that we don't go into disasters and then try to recover. It's always expensive in terms of human life that you walk into a disaster and then you try to correct. But this has been the human history. We are unconscious and compulsive in our activities. We walk into disasters and then we cry about it after it's over. So this is a kind of disaster. If we walk into it, many of us will not walk out of it, because the biodiversity loss is happening at such a pace. According to UNFAO, the biodiversity loss is about 27,000 species per year is going into extinction. At this rate, it's sliding right now. At this rate, somewhere in between 25 to 40 years, nobody is sure about the date, but somewhere between 25 to 40 years it could happen, the biodiversity will go into a tumble. When it goes into a tumble, there is nothing you or me can do anything about it. If you want to act, it's now.
So you were talking about increasing the, what do you call,
organic
component. Organic component in the soil from 3 to 6%. I think in India it is not even 3% now.
No. It is 0.68% is the average.
Yeah.
Which is desertification. Below 1% in the world is considered desertification. It's already on.
Okay. So what is the solution for this?
See, organic content comes from only two sources. Not just on this planet, in the entire universe, there are only two sources. Plant life and animal life. If plant life and animal life doesn't come back on the farms, there is no way you can put it back. People talk about technologies and technologies. Technologies can enhance application, but technologies cannot create organic content. Organic content will come only from plant source and animal sources. But both of them have disappeared from the farms, and it has to come back one way or the other. In what way? It's up to you. This is why we made the policy handbook. There were 500 pages on this. There are hundreds of ways in which you can do it. How you do it is left to you, but it must be done. Organic content has to come back into the soil, because this is the food for the organisms. Organic content means it's a food for the organisms. Organisms means they are miniature human beings. They are the ones who became like this. This complex life has happened because of this incessant work that they have done for millions of years. Now we are threatening their life. That means we are pulling out the foundations of this building and wanting to see when it'll collapse. It will, for sure. When may be debatable, but it will.
You happened to meet so many leaders of these countries when you traveled all these 90 days. So, what is their response? Are they willing to make any policy decisions on this?
See, the response has been uniformly positive, but…
Do you think that it will happen? Because when you meet them, they'll definitely say diplomatically that we'll do it.
The response has been absolutely positive, but their hands are tied in many things, even if they wish to. The reason why their hands are tied is, soil is treated as one more problem along with the many environmental issues which are there, of carbon emissions, fossil fuels, coal, this one, that one, all kinds of things. So one important thing we are pushing for is separate soil from other issues, because other issues have economic concerns, that it may end up into a couple of decades of more debate as we've been debating for endlessly. Soil must be separated and treated as such, because nobody, no lobby, no industry, no farmer, no human being on the planet is against enhancing soil organic content. We are not talking about organic farming. Let farmer decide what kind of farming he wants to do. But is anybody in the world against making the soil rich? Nobody is against it, because it's against nobody. I've spoken to fertilizer companies, pesticide companies, nobody is against it. Who is against soil being rich? Nobody is against it. So you must separate soil from other concerns. Only then action will be possible. Implementable action is possible only then. This is what we are pushing for in the world bodies. This is what we are pushing for individual nations. This is what we are pushing for in India and all the states in India. Separate soil from other ecological concerns. Otherwise, we will just go on debating this forever.
And apart from the policy makers, it should also reach the masses, that is, be it the farmers or be it the common citizens.
See, the whole campaign is about reaching the masses, but what will the masses do apart from the farmers? They can only talk. So I'm telling them, you talk. At least don't talk in your private rooms, talk public. Talk on the platforms, make it visible, which they are doing in a phenomenal way. About farmers, don't worry about them. If you provide the necessary incentive, they will do it.
So, incentivizing the farmers is…
Incentivizing is the only way.
And disincentivizing them from using the chemicals and…
No. Right now, farmer is not ready for that. Any punitive action will not work with the farmer, because farm economy is that fragile. If you touch it, it'll collapse. Don't we understand this, because nearly 500,000 farmers have committed suicide across the world, not just in India. The highest suicide rate among any given profession in United States or Europe or any country is among the farmers. So when this is the case, punitive action is not going to work. We need incentives. We have created a three-pronged incentive process. One is government offers an incentive for raising it to minimum 3%, and then there's a carbon credit scheme which has to be simplified for the farmer. And the third is in the market, recognition must happen in the marketplace, whether I come from 1% organic content or 3% organic content or 6% organic content must be recognized, because we already have enough science to tell us if it is 3% organic content, what are the extra micronutrients present there, what are the health benefits, what are the preventive health benefits, and also what are the other benefits for the state in terms of reducing the stress on the healthcare system. More healthy human beings means more productive and creative population. All this data is there. We have to collate this and make sure the farmer benefits in the marketplace. So if my mango is coming from 1%, it sits on one shelf. If it's coming from 3%, it sits on another shelf. It sits on… if it's 6%, another shelf. The most important aspect of this is, you can check the soil organic content at the farm level, you don't have to go to the lab. The moment, right now, whole lot of scientists have promoted testing the soil carbon content. If you want to test the carbon content, you have to go to the lab. The moment it goes to the lab in a country like India, for example, in our courts, many serious issues which matter for individual people in their lives, their property, their business, whatever, have been lying for 25 years in waiting list. Over 1.6 crore or 1.5 crore cases are waiting. The same will happen to soil testing. It's important, we must be able to test it on the land, right there. Farmer himself is able to test it and show it on the video, see, this is my soil, what will you give me?
True. How is the response from our own country, the leadership of our country? I think you met the Prime Minister on this.
Prime Minister is deeply invested in this process, but central government doesn't have a geography of their own. All the six states we have passed through, Gujarat, Rajasthan, UP, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and now Telangana, all of them have signed MOUs that they will work in this direction.
State.
Yes, because the geography is with the state, all right, the land is in the state's hands. So this is a state issue, but the central government will have to give a recommendation policy and maybe some incentives for the states to move in that direction.
In the plan allocations,
yes,
and the finance
so
commissions.
So we will work with the Niti Aayog to see how certain amount of money can go, which has already happened for Rally for Rivers policy, what we made. See, we made the Rally for Rivers policy for the very first time. The government of India accepted the policy written by a private organization, which has never happened in the history of this nation. And it became the official recommended policy for all the 28 states. But six states went into reasonable action, others didn't do much about it. Even these six states dropped this activity when the pandemic struck. In the last 2 years, nothing has happened. So we manifested a project in the Kaveri Basin. Kaveri Basin accounts for 83,000 square kilometers, 5.2 million farmers. We started manifesting this project. Looking at the success of this, 9 UN agencies have become partners with us now. Looking at the success of this, central government made a detailed project report for 13 river basins. These 13 river basins account for 67% of India's land or agricultural land. So we were trying to push that into action. Just now when I was riding through Eastern Europe, I got the news that central government allocated 19,000 crores for these 13 river basins. This is a way forward, but it took 11 years to get to this place of action. But it is good that it is moving in the direction. Another 8 to 12 years, if they invest like this, 67% of India's land will be above crest. But central government, how much incentive it gives to the state and to what extent state is willing to add incentive to that and make it attractive for the farmer not to ignore this, that it's not a small incentive that he can ignore. It is significant enough that no farmer would want to ignore this. Right now, many incentives are given which are not result-oriented, simply incentives. Because their economy is in such a bad place, when some bad agriculture year happens, maybe you have to do that. But incentives aimed towards a certain goal are always better, and stronger incentives can be given so that goals are achieved.
So సో వాట్ నెక్స్ట్ 100 రోజుల ప్రయాణం మీరు పూర్తి చేస్తున్నారు అండ్ 9 రాష్ట్రాలతో ఎంఓయూలు
నాట్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇమిడియట్లీ ఇట్ ఇస్ స్టార్టింగ్ బికాజ్ ఆల్రెడీ G20 మీటింగ్స్ ఆర్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ ఆన్ 21st వెన్ ఐ గెట్ టు ఆశ్రమ్ ఆల్రెడీ టీమ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ క్యారికామ్ టీమ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఫ్రమ్ కరేబియన్ నేషన్స్ సో దే వాంట్ టు టేక్ ఇట్ అహెడ్ ద లాట్ ఆఫ్ లీడర్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్ అ రష్ టు మూవ్ అహెడ్ బికాస్ suddenly people are asking what is this soil in this condition what have we done why nothing has been done these questions have been you know in some countries it's very vocal and people's voices are strong in some countries it's not so much so let's say a place like United States nobody raises the voices that country is made in a different way we have to work differently but in European nations the voices are strong in Caribbean nations voices are strong some of the African nations voices are strong India voice is strong you will see all governments will respond. Now our responsibility, I feel, is only managing the speed because the direction and the narrative has been set.
So Sadhguru, you said it has taken 11 years for the rally for rivers to progress and at least some concrete developments are taking place now. So save the soil will also take the same time, if not more. And you said only 60 years more for soil extinction. So, how can we speed up this process?
See, you might have taken 11-12 years in school to learn a language, ABC and then words and sentences. Later on, you don't take the same time, isn't it? So, it need not take the same amount of time because now everybody is conscious about it.
At this age, 65 years age, you took 100 days yatra on the motorcycle. So what is driving you? Is it purely sankalpa balam?
I'm driving.
Sankalpa balam or any?
No ghosts or devils driving, just me driving.
Okay. Driving alone is of course a dangerous thing. We hope you'll not face any dangers.
If the danger was not there, nobody would have sat up. People wouldn't have come awake if the danger was not there. Their response is to danger only. Not to my words, unfortunately.
Okay.
It's the danger which has woken them up. So, they may better wake up and make it happen, otherwise I'll do something much more dangerous maybe.
Let's hope the humankind will respond to your request and save the soil. From now, we'll talk the soil, sing the soil, like you said, breathe the soil.
We must do that.
Yeah.
As media, you have immense responsibility. This is a generational responsibility. So, save soil, let's make it happen.
Sure, sir. Namaskaram, Sadhguru. Thanks for giving us this interview.